Hey everyone, today's Photoshop question was sent to ask@tutcast.com from Jay. And his question is, I have a small problem. A friend of mine showed me how to do this technique for digital photography. You take a picture in RAW mode and make sure you bracket. Then you merge them in RAW to get this really amazing image. I can't remember for the life of me how this technique is called or how exactly to do it. Any ideas? Thanks. Now, Jay, what you're referring to is called HDR, which stands for High Dynamic Range, and it's typically done using three or more images, all of different exposures, to create a final image where the light is evenly distributed throughout the image. Many times you'll find yourself with an image that contains areas that are either too light or too dark. This technique will help neutralize those areas by using the proper lighting from the other images in the stack. And some artists also use this technique to create surrealistic images. Let me show you what I mean. Here we have three images, all taken at different exposures. A neutral image, a low exposure shot, and a high exposure shot. Hopping into Photoshop, Adobe has given us a great tool to help merge all these images together. Head up to the File menu, down to Automate, and then Merge to HDR Pro. If you're on a version lower than CS5, your HDR features may be a little bit different than mine. Once you're here, we need to select all three images. It's usually a good idea to have Photoshop align your images for you, just in case they're not all perfectly lined up. Now that I've pressed OK, Photoshop will start preparing the images. It's going to analyze all three images and figure out which areas of each image to use in the final result. Now that Photoshop has aligned and neutralized the image, you can go ahead and make some additional changes if you like. In CS5, Photoshop comes with some handy presets. These may help if you're looking for a specific style, such as black and white, a very saturated look, or something just a little bit simple like photorealistic. Finish up by tweaking the settings below, then you're good to go. You can go ahead and upload it on Facebook or on Twitter. And speaking of Twitter, if you have Photoshop questions, feel free to follow and reply to Iceflow Studios or email ask@tutcast.com. Take care.